Welcome back to Kansas City, Arrowhead Stadium, where your Kansas City Chiefs deliver a thumping over the Oakland Raiders, 40-9 in a statement game,
putting
the Kansas City Chiefs a comfortable two-game lead in the division, technically three because the Kansas City Chiefs own the tiebreaker over the Raiders. Again, the Kansas City Chiefs win 40-9. I'm here with Lance Twidwell of The Spoken, Trevor Twidwell of The Spoken. Lance, I want to get your opinion. The Chiefs came out, big interception, Tyrann Mathieu set the tone. The Chiefs went down, scored a four-yard touchdown pass to Darrell Williams. What did you take away from not only maybe the opening drive, but this game, Lance?
Oh, there's a lot to take away from this one, guys, in particular. I just hope that Derek Carr got to the Chiefs locker room on time to get to his dad, Patrick Mahomes, get out of this cold as soon as possible. That's all I'm concerned about, most likely. I mean, 0-6 now in his six turn trips here in Kansas City. I think it's time that Derek Carr realizes that his calling is not football. But furthermore into this game, guys, I think it's a telling game. We talked about on our show Friday night that the Chiefs really needed to reestablish dominance in the AFC West, in particular in the AFC, to show that even though the Ravens are absolutely balling, the Patriots are still the Patriots. The Chiefs need to remember who they are and where they were last season. And they can get right back to it because they have all the talent in the world. They are the most talented team in the AFC. And tonight, in a lot of ways, they showed that once again. There's a lot to work on in this game, as there was a lot to work on. The offense did not have a lot of rhythm tonight again. There's a lot of shakiness in that part of the game. But the Chiefs came out here and won a game as a team and dropped 40 points for the first time since week one. So I'm going to cheer. I'm going to celebrate this one for sure.
Hell yes, Trevor. I heard you on The Spoken recently talking about the Kansas City Chiefs identity. What is the identity of this team? We look at it 1 week, it's the defense carrying. Yeah. 1 week, it's the offense carrying, but the defense lets us down. Looking at this game in totality, what can you take of this game about the Kansas City Chiefs identity?
I still want to see more of an offensive identity. We saw some good things offensively tonight, but I still want to see some more down the field. Passes. We saw some of those tonight. There were some were dropped. Obviously, we had some early drops in the game, but I felt we took care of things that we needed to tighten up on, which are special teams. And our defense has obviously looked stout for about three straight weeks now. And then our defense is going out there showing that we own the division, which is, showing that we are the class of this division, the big daddy of this division. So, main thing, I was looking for was more down the field passes. We got Kelsey on a couple of those. Tyreek looked great tonight. He looked spry. Pat still looks a little off his game a little bit, still coming off that injury, but he's still working out some things. But overall, just dominant performance all aspects of the game. I felt like we could have put up 60 plus tonight, easy. But it's just more capitalizing in the red zone. Still, I want to see more of that. But I can see that we're slowly but surely getting that identity back that we saw last year.
The 2019 draft class had a game today.
Yes, sir.
Juan Thornhill with the big pick six.
Yep.
Rashad Fenton with the big fumble on a kickoff. The man continues to grow. The man continues to blossom. Mecole Hardman didn't get much receptions, but he's still out there. He's still a threat. Lance, I think the Chiefs are going to be a 3 or a 4 seed. It doesn't bother me. I honestly, and this is going to blow people's mind because they're not going to like it, I trust the Kansas City Chiefs in January more than I do in December. Let's get us there. Yep. If the Chiefs have to play Buffalo or Tennessee right here in January the first week, I won't have a problem with that. Lance, there's still 4 weeks to play. I know you're vying for a bye. Who wouldn't want a bye? What do you take away going into New England next week?
Oh, this game is the game of the year. Let's make no mistake about it, guys. This game is something. Last couple years when we had the Patriots, you think, okay, look, the Patriots have all the advantages here. That's not true anymore. The Patriots have the worst offense amongst all contending teams in the NFL, and it's not close. The Chiefs can go in there this next week, and win this game. And that's the attitude they need to have. They need to go in there, pressure Tom Brady, and let Patrick Mahomes sling the ball over the field. Because that defense is beatable. Now, here's the disadvantage. The fact that the biggest weakness for the Patriots defense has been against the rush. And that's the Chiefs' biggest weakness on offense. So it's going to be interesting to see what kind of game plan Andy Reid would write up. But make no mistake about it, guys. The 3 seed isn't the only one that's in play. The 2 seed is still very much in play for the Chiefs as well.
Yep.
There's a lot of chips that can still fall. So the Chiefs need to do their best to win out and give themselves their own destiny and their own hands. Do not need to be relying on any other teams. Don't worry about what the Texans are doing, who currently own the tiebreaker on the Chiefs. Don't worry about what the Ravens are doing, who are absolutely balling out, but the Chiefs own the tiebreaker on them. There's a lot, like I said, there's a lot of chips that still need to fall. The Chiefs just need to worry about their own shit. Take care of your own shit, and shit will get done.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Kansas City Chiefs freaks worldwide of all ages. That is Lance and Trevor Twidwell of The Spoken. Stick to Red Tribe Cinema. They're got a big special tonight that's going to be debuting. You are going to want to watch it. It's going to be something special. It's Thanksgiving weekend. The Chiefs dominated. For Lance Twidwell and Trevor Twidwell of the Spoken, this is Shaggyshane saying, ladies and gentlemen, Patriots, we're coming at you, baby. We're coming at you.
Let's go.
Go Chiefs.
Let's go.